the stereotypes of lip syncing and having no creative control and just being about dancing and not really having any talent. If those weren't that wasn't the stigma about being a boy band, I don't think anybody would mind being referred to as that. But I just think being considered a boy band really limits you as far as what you can do musically and professionally. I mean, it really puts a blockade on how long you can stay in this business.
Right. I mean, I agree. I mean, people think that if you're in a boy band, you don't write music, you don't produce music, that you were put together by some mastermind and you're just a bunch of puppets really marketed towards young teen girls. And that's not the case with us. I mean, we put ourselves together for music.
Singing, it's more of a performance. When you're on stage, it's kind of like an escape. You can get up there and do whatever, and it's not necessarily you, it's just what you want to do. I mean, it's not necessarily what Drew or Jeff would do walking down the street, but you're given a lot more freedom. And I think that that's a big reason about art in general, whether it's painting, music, dance, it allows you to express yourself in ways that you couldn't just verbally. So I think for us, it's definitely a kind of a release, kind of a way of expressing ourselves. And I mean, a lot of the songs we're writing recently have become more expressions of ourselves, things that have made us mad, things that we're going through, just, I mean, different things. So I think, like I said earlier, the more you write, the better you get, and the more it really expresses yourself. They don't become cliches, they become stories about your life. So I think definitely you can express yourself better through song than you can through verbalization. It's all, it's all.
I think a lot of times your music reflects your personality, and we're very romantic guys. I mean, we're not softies or anything like that, but we're in between a softie and a, I don't know, I don't think we're too soft, but, you know, we're definitely romantic guys. We're guys that fall, I mean, at least me anyway, I can speak for myself, I fall easily for a pretty face and a nice girl with a good sense of humor. It doesn't take much for me. But we usually sing music that's from the heart and also that other people can relate to. And love is definitely something that everyone can relate to, and it's a universal appeal. And That's why we sing the songs we do. We like to pick songs with kind of cool lyrics, you know, lyrics with a different twist. Invisible Man, The Hardest Thing are good examples of that. You know, so, you know, we just like to sing things that we care about, sing about things that we care about, and love is obviously a very major, major part of our lives.
Never sit back, relax, and enjoy it, or else that's when you fall. You can never get complacent. You can never become. You can be satisfied with the goals you've achieved, but you can't be content. You have to just keep setting new goals for yourself and raising the bar, raising the standard. Even if you sold more records than anybody else in the world, you gotta try to set a new goal, reach another standard, raise the bar, or else you're just gonna get lazy and just fall off. You gotta continue to set goals. And that's what we did our whole career. We had the goal of, all right, we want to get signed. All right, we want to get our record out. We want to go top 10. We want to have a platinum album. We just kept setting new goals and raising the bar. And now, I mean, we got a triple platinum album in the States, platinum albums, platinum Christmas albums. So we just gotta keep raising the bar. And the next album is very exciting for us.
And those goals are all cool, and you know, and for us, those aren't the primary goals to be met. The primary goals for us are, of course, the musical goals. And you know, our big thing now is to write more, get more creative as artists, use other elements of music, not just pop, but R&B and rock and other types of music, jazz, even more, and make us more well-rounded musicians, make more of a creation that people can distinguish us from other people. And that's one of our main goals that we're working on now.
Shouldn't be here. This is wrong. And baby, it's killing me. It's killing you. Both of us trying to be strong. I got somewhere else to be. Promises to keep. Someone else who loves me and trusted me fast asleep. I made up my mind. There is no turning back. She's been good to me. And she deserves better than that.
It's the hardest thing I'll ever have to do. To look you in the eye and tell you I don't love you. It's the hardest thing I'll ever have to lie. To show no emotion when you start to cry. I can't let you see what you mean to me. When hands are tied and my heart's not free,
and I'm meant to be.
It's the hardest thing I'll ever have to do.
Oh,
to turn around and walk away, pretending I don't love you.
We'll meet again. Fate is a place and time, so you can get on with your life. I've got to be cruel. Be kind, like Dr. Zhivago. All my love I'll be sending, and you will never know, 'cause there can be no happiness.